We did say that you guys would stick around for questions after the meeting was over.
Mr. Chairman.
Sir.
I don't believe that we as a majority budget committee can discuss issues related to the budget committee outside of a meeting.
Right.
Putting 91A, according to what we just learned in our presentation, actually, as well. We do know that the NHMA is happy to entertain questions only off camera. So I would suggest that we simply turn the camera off and then continue.
I think in order to turn the camera off, we would have to adjourn the meeting.
No, not true.
No, so the
chairman has control of the camera going on and off. If you instruct the camera crew to turn off the camera, they'll turn off the camera.
But if
they'll turn it back on when you tell them to turn it back on.
But if you do that, you're still meeting.
Yes, correct, and that's still in compliance with 91A. No, 91A does not require the camera to be on during the meeting.
Hang on one second.
Page 6 has no right to.
How are they going to take minutes?
We would have to then be able to have the ability to administer minutes for the segment that was not broadcasted.
No.
If we were still in a meeting without adjourning, we would have to have minutes for that because it would still be a meeting. The questions that are going to be asked, as we are asking legal inquiries of the NHMA, I would prefer to adjourn the meeting and ask a legal inquiries in regards to this subject matter, and have those inquiries be where they are town-specific, kept with attorney-client privilege. Either that, or I can suggest that all questions be sent to me in writing, and we will get them to NHMA in writing, and I can forego a question and answer session altogether, if that's not a good option as well. But I figured that NHMA is here. They are here for us to ask questions. They are a wonderful resource. I would just recommend adjourning the meeting and asking the questions that we have.
I will make a motion to adjourn the meeting.
So I'll second questions. It. I'll second the discussion.
I would open the table for discussion.
Page 6, you just got the pass out. Middle box, it's a lot of meetings. Bullet point 2, budget committee governing body meetings, unlimited number, public meeting rule only, 91A.
In other words, we don't want to adjourn the meeting because we're going to have a quorum here at the committee.
Absolutely.
And I make a motion we continue the meeting until we are completely finished with our presentation.
Well, before
and
I
all
entertain
questions.
Your motion, we still have
Chairman.
Hang on 1 second.
I think that's an illegal meeting.
We still have a illegal meeting is not a meeting with a council. That is not an illegal meeting.
But the Board of Selectmen,
hold on. I'll wait, Ms. Wellesley. Ms. Wellesley, the Board of Selectmen meet with council all the time, and they don't record those meetings. There is no minutes of those meetings because it is under attorney-client privilege.
We're not the Board of
Chairman, ma'am.
I am suggesting that this board adjourn the meeting. We have a question session with council and then move on. Mr. Jones.
In order for there to be an attorney-client privilege invocation, there must be an attorney and their client. These people are not our attorneys.
Right.
We are not their client.
Let me just jump in right there.
Oh, good.
We are not their client.
We do have an attorney-client relationship with the town of Hampton.
Right.
That is true.
Not with the budget committee itself.
And budget committee is part of the town of Hampton. So all of our communications that we have with a community are covered by the attorney-client privilege. And when you communicate with us to the legal advisory service or ask us questions in this situation, mm-hmm. that's covered by the attorney-client privilege. That's a confidential relationship. There's no doubt about that.
And just to be very clear, consultation with legal counsel is not a meeting under the right to know law.
Okay.
That being said,
mm-hmm. I have not finished.
Sure.
If I understand the presentation by Steve, he's claiming to be the attorney for the town of Hampton.
No, I'm claiming that we have an attorney-client relationship.
Right. You are an attorney for the town of Hampton.
I'm claiming we have an attorney-client relationship. The attorney for the town of Hampton is the town attorney.
Well,
you can have
attorney.
More than one attorney. We have an attorney-client relationship.
Right.
That's all that's
but
necessary.
But you're an attorney for the town of Hampton.
I am the attorney for the town through the New Hampshire Municipal Association. Correct. Right.
And under that basis, you're claiming that there is an attorney-client relationship which can be accommodated under the non-meeting clause of 91A.
That is correct.
So we can go into a non-meeting under 91A.
Correct.
We do not adjourn the meeting. We go into a non-meeting, correct?
Okay. Right.
It would be a non-public session.
When the Board of Selectmen does this, they do it by going into a non-meeting. Right. They explicitly do not go and adjourn. They do not adjourn. They call for a roll call vote to go into a non-meeting.
Right.
Am I not correct, Steve?
Well, I think it's semantics here. I guess I would say most people think when you use the word adjourn is you are coming out of a public meeting. So I think it's more accurate to say when you adjourn, you come out of a public meeting and you enter some other activity, which under the law is a non-meeting. So I think it's proper to say you're adjourning your public session to go into a non-meeting for the purpose of consultation with legal counsel.
Right, as long as we're clear we're not adjourning the meeting itself.
Well,
because we're having a non-meeting, right? Semantics is everything.
Miss Barnes.
I make a motion to go into a non-meeting with legal counsel from NHMA.
There's already two motions on the table.
We already had a motion.
We already have one motion on the table.
There's two.
Well, you have the adjournment one that Brian made, and I seconded.
We're going to address the...
And the one I made. Thank you.
We can only have one at a time.
Just did this
correct.
Last night. Did you?
I would like to remind everybody that NHMA is on a time frame. They can only be here until 9 o'clock.
Call for a vote.
I am going to call for a vote on the motion that's on the table that has been seconded. And the motion was made by Mr. Lapham and seconded by Mr. LaBranche. To adjourn the meeting and go into a session of question and answer with the NHMA.
And I'll be voting no on that in hopes that we can have a motion to go into a non-meeting.
All those in favor of adjourning the meeting, please keep your hands raised. I'm going to do an auditory vote.
What was the question again?
Adjourn the meeting.
Adjourn and go into a questions and answer session. Ms. Bridle, Ms. Barnes, Mr. Lapham, Mr. Fluff, Chairman Bridle, Mr. LaBranche, Ms. Augustine, Mr. Henderson. All those opposed? Mr. Pierce, Ms. Wolseley, those abstaining?
I oppose.
You oppose. Mr. Jones opposes as well. That being said, I will call the meeting adjourned at 8:40 p.m.